Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Book of Unwritten Tales 2. Blind. Anyway, we are now controlling Nate. Critter just woke him up with the Glug Glug X, otherwise known as Hangover Healer, I believe it was called. Anyway, Nate can actually read the notices, so let's see.
We, the Pirates of Pirates Illand, demand that his head disappear from our Illand immediately. Signatured XXX, 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 and so on.
These guys are so literate, huh?
This town has long been the heart of piratedom in Aventasia, at least for the flying pirates. Every stone, every nail, all stolen from somewhere by hard-working pirates.
Oh, the palace? We're not looking at notices anymore?
But I say...
Wait, what? Oh, crap, I missed it. Alright, you guys can, pause. Sorry about that. Pillory.
Me and the short guy over there were quite sure Red wouldn't do me any harm, for the time being, at least. He's a gambler and a collector, and he likes winning. He would have savored his victory first of all. And before he hung me up as a warning, we'd have been long gone with the lamp.
If you look into the abyss...
They look so real.
The abyss looks into you. Let's see what he says. He sees.
No one knows exactly why this island is flying. Most people suspect it's down to a failed magical experiment or a joke of the gods. Either way, it was the perfect hiding place for airborne pirates.
How do we know? Is it the same? How do they know where it's going to be when they come back?
The island sometimes flies higher or lower depending on the temperature and time of year. At the moment, we should be floating about 4,000 to 5,000 meters over the Umzu Desert.
You figure it would be extremely windy, but nope. Water trough? Thirsty? Dehydrated?
A water trough isn't such a comfortable place for a drunk to sleep, as one might guess. But what can you do? You gotta uphold the traditions.
Is that a tradition, to sleep in a water trough?
At first I thought they might be new pieces for the Red Pirate's collection. But then he'd surely have them in his palace and not out here.
Is there a Medusa wandering the place?
I asked the Red Pirate about the statues. He avoided the question and ordered the next round.
Hey, Critter.
Hey, partner.
What the hell did you pour down my throat?
Whatever you poured down my throat, it worked. I haven't been this sober for weeks.
For weeks?
That wasn't a compliment.
I think we have to work together if we want to get off this island.
It's time for teamwork, Critter. We'll only get the lamp and get off this island if we work together. You distract him, I bash him on the head. I get shot at, you jump in front of me. You know, teamwork.
Jump in front of him. Alright, see you later, little friend.
See you later, Critter.
Break out! Let's look at the palm tree. It was coconut tree.
I actually like coconut milk. But after that drink Critter gave me, I wouldn't even drink it from the belly button of... I don't want any coconut milk.
Okay, so forgive my ignorance, but I guess coconuts come from palm trees? I thought it was a coconut tree.
I don't know what else there is to talk about. Me and Critter, it's in them.
It's in the bag. Let's see if he can look at this. Come on, pan back. Pan back. Pan back. Let's look at the souvenir shop.
life of a pirate
get
isn't
up there so quick.
You have to look for alternative sources of income now. Ringtones, promotional events, merchandising.
Ringtones?
Kind of. This shop wasn't here when I lived here. It seems to have been abandoned at short notice, just like everything else. If the clothes I have now weren't of much higher quality than these pirate t-shirts, this would be the ideal opportunity for a bit of thieving.
Alas. Alright, let's go to the jetty. To the Mary with us. Hello, strange bird.
A real pirate's bird. His father was probably a parrot with a chick in every port.
That's a pretty sad sounding bird.
Hey, you ugly bird.
Get off those peanuts, you ugly bird!
He can talk.
Yeah, well, he's repeating what people said to him.
You think I could persuade you to turn a blind eye while we disappear with the Mary?
Let's get out of here! I won't stay on this island another day!
Oh, you want to come with us? Fantastic!
Oh, Nate.
I've got a new artifact! It's fantastic!
You're just blabbering any old garbage.
You're just blabbering any old garbage! What?
The ape in the palace? The parrot here? Well, Red seems to favor animal guards.
True.
Mind you, he hasn't got much choice.
Yeah.
The ape in the palace? Mind.
Let's take a look at the bit with a pan on it.
There's salt in the pan. I can imagine Critter's responsible for this. It would seem that while I was analyzing our situation in the water trough, he was just causing mischief.
What? He woke you up.
The padlock really does look magical. I wonder whether...
Alert!
Shh! All right, already. Look, but don't touch. I get it.
I don't see what the problem is. I don't think the monkey or Red can hear us all the way down in the town inside the palace.
The lens was mostly used to dramatically shorten the getaway of airships whose occupants had incurred the wrath of the Red Pirate. My Mary. Red Pirate himself chained her up when we arrived. I wasn't expecting that. Granted, it did used to be his ship, and he's attached to her. A huge magic padlock? It's a bit over the top, if you ask me.
Well, it keeps you from stealing her back, doesn't it?
I wonder whether open the padlock and let it rain gold would pass as one wish.
Something skipped by.
We'll see as soon as we've got the oil lamp.
I swear I clicked it just once, guys.
Once we've got the gin, the rest has to follow really quickly. I wonder whether open...
That's the rest, okay. So we can't even look at this anymore.
I wonder where...
See that?
Once we've got...
Click once.
Once we've got... I wonder...
Okay, well, it's working now. Anything else to look at here? Not really. Okay. Alright, let's go in here. Excalibur.
An old sword in a rock.
Yeah, same thing.
That poses several questions. What did the poor rock do wrong to make someone want to stab him? Who had enough strength to drive the sword into the rock? And above all, who profits from murder? God, I'd make a fantastic detective.
No, you wouldn't. That second question's a fair one, though. Okay. Come on, King Arthur.
What would I want with an old sword? Anyway, it's probably rather blunt. Who knows how many rocks it's stabbed already.
Right. Okay. No reason to look at the cornucopia for him. Let's look at this cloth.
He didn't let this bundle out of his grasp all evening and refused to show me what's in it. He was almost shocked when I wanted to see it.
It's his vibrator. Hey! Got the wrong icon for talk. Talk.
What? I've got it all. Can't live.
For now.
Gold and power.
He seems to be having a nightmare. Perhaps someone should wake him up. But I haven't forgotten how he had a bounty put on my head for years, just because I was better at cheating in poker than him. The Mary was the only thing he ever lost. Or as he puts it, had stolen from him.
Alone. All alone.
He's always needed the attention and admiration of others, even if we did make fun of him behind his back. Completely alone, stranded on a desert island, it can only end in tears. I'll let him sleep. I know what he's capable of. And back then, he wasn't quite as nutty as he is today.
Oh, yeah, huh?
I'll let him
Okay, yeah, compass. Maybe he'll take the compass. Get over there.
Spirit compass. The needle's spinning all the time. I can't imagine that's worth much. Who would want a compass that doesn't point north?
Yeah, I guess it's not that kind of compass. Look under the cloth.
Just a little bitty peek.
Ooh, mate, are you mad?
Just wanted to have a little look.
No one could look at it. It's dreadful.
Dreadful?
Oh, okay. I didn't know that. Fine. I won't do it again.
What is it? Is Justin Bieber doll? What is under the cloth?
Got your newest acquisition under that cloth?
It's dreadful.
If it's dreadful, why don't you just lock it away?
It's wondrous, too. It's so powerful.
And valuable? More valuable than, let's say, that magic lamp over there?
You can defeat whole armies with it. Do you understand?
What is it, crack?
I had to try it out. What's the point of having that kind of power and not using it?
That would be irresponsible.
Exactly. When there's something you can do, you have to do it.
Really? Where are all the pirates?
Tell me, where are all the other pirates?
Gone. Left me. All on my own. All of them. Most of them. Mooching around Pirate's Bay, living off other people's work. That's not what I call honest pirating.
I think we should go back to sleep. Especially you.
You're not gonna leave me, are you?
What? No. We feel extremely content on your deserted flying rock.
Oh, that's good. That's good.
He is.
Okay.
He's planning on executing us.
I want to get off of here. Immediately. I'll let him sleep. I know it. Rat has always been bad at that. Giving away something once he's held it in his hands. That's what made him
Excuse
into the
me.
Richest and most powerful pirate. He took what he could and gave nothing back. A role model for everyone.
Think so, huh?
Rat has always been. That's a role model.
Look at the lamp. They don't mess around with the drinks and the monkey. Maybe we can get his fez.
There's a lot of valuable things in here, but that there is the crown jewel. A magic lamp with a djinn living inside it who grants you 3 wishes. He'll make me rich and powerful so I'm finally worthy.
Worthy? Of what? Oh, do you have to be royalty to, marry, Ivo. Yeah. This will completely work.
I wonder whether I can just...
What's going on?
Nothing, nothing, nothing at all. As I feared, a hairy alarm system and a crystal dome, too. My bounty hunter friend can crack that, but first I need to turn off the alarm. As I feared, my...
Big book of cocktails.
Fortunately, Critter's drink has ensured I got out of this without feeling sick and having a headache. But it's still going to be a while before I stick my nose in a book like that again.
Peanuts.
A few old peanuts in a dirty bowl. A dinner for champions.
All right, now we got peanuts.
A couple of old peanuts. Not even salted.
See, they're not salted.
A few more won't do any harm.
How many peanuts do we need?
A few more won't do any harm.
I guess we could take a limitless amount.
That's the guy who mixed me all the drinks.
Right.
You should be ashamed of yourself giving a man what he wants like that. We want to steal the oil lamp without being noticed, so we've got to get rid of that ape. The Red Pirate's got loads of magical toys and an extremely unstable psyche. A dangerous combination. A fight would be too loud and over quickly. I've seen a pirate ape sink a ship with his bare hands. We want to steal the oil lamp without the Red Pirate's got...
All right, what else?
He's incorruptible, and he's Red's right-hand man, and the barkeeper. I won't get anywhere with nuts.
Alright. No Critter.
Malaka boom boom.
Malaka boom boom.
Malaka boom boom.
Teamwork time. Hey, Nate.
Oh,
attack. Glug, glug.
Yeah, I know. I should have poured away one or two of those drinks like we planned. But you know how it is.
They're just so good. He doesn't know what it is.
Come on. When Layla flew off, you just wanted to forget it all, too.
Layla.
Layla.
We'll get them back, buddy. Both of them.
Lapuka.
Lapuka.
From what I hear,
the lamps
are unbelievably powerful.
Puku Salada.
Magic.
Should be enough to save us both a load of problems.
Which means what? I think... Eat something? Drink something?
Alright then.
What? Oh, you take over? Is that what that means?
Hey, partner.
You take over.
I need to think things over. You take over for a bit.
Okay, so Burulol means... Chocolate Pregal.
Chocolate Pregal.
See you later.
If we get the Brunsela Mary, Now, can I switch? Can't switch to him? Here, take it. Go this way. Take it. Take it.
My bounty hunter friend.
Ugh.
Now I'm cured of that. For now.
Alright. Let's try to take his fez again. See what happens. Like the glass.
Stop this thing.
Oh wait. I thought I switched to Nate. Let's try the grog or whatever. Can Nate take the glass? Take the glass, Nate. Take the glass. Take... Nate, you're an idiot.
Hey, partner.
No.
I need to think things over. You take over for a bit.
I want to try this one more time. I'll order something else, though. See if we have any use for an empty glass, the whatever baboon's bottom.
Bottom.
You drink it, and you stop moving screen, stop moving. Take the, oh. Okay, never mind. Okay, both have peanuts. He just has peanuts. Okay, I'm gonna mess around with things a little bit again, and I'm gonna do this off screen, so not to bore you guys and have you see me do things repetitively and with like no I don't know what you call it. Nothing good happens from what I do. In other words, boring to watch. So see you on the flip side. Okay, figured out what to do. Sure, okay, hold on 1 second. Resuming time. Okay, I think you do this with either member. Either of them. But I'm just going to do it with Neat. Apparently, once you give this bird peanuts, more than once.
Do you like peanuts?
Now I'm not sure with Critter because I don't really communicate, but
another peanut?
He seems to hold back the peanut.
Ah! Da, na, 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 na.
Or neener neener. So what we can do is go like this. And switch to Critter. I guess we should have had him in better positions. But I think we have plenty of time. Take this blanket. Take the lid.
Haarrshot-gueila.
Now, if we don't do this, the bird will come and fly here forever. And it didn't work for me. It was just stuck in him flying, and I couldn't move anyone around anywhere.
Yoo-hoo!
Yoo-hoo! Still don't know how to open it. Still can't burn stuff. We can look at this crate. I know we can look at that. Oh, it's a duplicate Fez. Oh yeah, you've got something in mind, don't you? This might be something time sensitive, so let's get everyone in here. Now, I know he puts his Fez down if we order the Burning Mary. Time he doesn't. Swap the Fez, what's he say? Oh, it's too big. Yeah, I wonder what would happen.
Now all we have to do is get you out of there.
Okay, it took care of it automatically.
Right. How long will it take? In the meantime, I could...
Yeah, how long would it take?
And that's why you should always have a reliable partner.
There was nothing, really.
Oh, I wasn't talking to you.
Ha, Critter. Ooh.
Now let's get out of here.
Wow. He was afraid of the gnome stealing it from
get
us.
Get ready for the big show, Critter.
How do we get the magic lock off? Oh, with the genie. Hello. Oh,
hello. You're a new one.
Ta-da!
What?
Aren't you supposed to put on a big show?
Oh. Is this before the intro of the game?
Good grief.
The game started off with him falling through the air. So I guess this is how that all starts. You sure that you are the djinn of the lamp?
I always thought djinns were godlike super magicians with healthy egos.
Oh, yeah, they're great.
But aren't you a djinn too?
Oh, well, yes, that's true, of course.
I mean, not that you aren't great. I just thought you'd be bigger.
More intimidating.
My brothers are all bigger.
Godlike.
They serve the most powerful rulers in the universe. Me, you know, they sent me here to practice. Mm. They said no one in this strange old world would really notice if I screwed things up.
Great. What's your name, by the way?
Nate's the name, but you can call me Master Nate. What's yours?
Master Nate.
Benjamin bin Nabil Tafik bin Akram Kamal bin Abbas ibn Hadshi.
Okay, Ben.
I'll call you Benny.
You're supposed to grant me 3 wishes, right?
As you're a djinn, you have to grant me 3 wishes, right?
Of course. Yes, sure.
But
it would be nice if... Well, can we agree on 3 small wishes?
No. I demand my awesome wishes. How do you define small wishes?
You mean if I want my own kingdom with immeasurable riches, then it's only allowed to be a small kingdom?
Yes, well, I could perhaps come up with a coin.
A coin?
I'm trying to impress an elf princess. Do you really think a coin is going to blow her away?
I'm just not that good at magic.
Not that good at magic?
Oh, God.
Take 10 breaths and count deeply. All in good time, Nate. All in good time.
My first wish, open the magic padlock.
Let's start with something easy. Open that.
Oh.
Oh?
It's not really that easy.
Not that easy?
You can do anything, though.
Please, don't pressure me. I don't like it when people get on my back.
Concentrate and open it. That's my wish.
All right, then.
Oh.
I did it!
Great.
Did you see that?
The padlock. You're supposed to open the padlock.
My God.
But that's a magic padlock. I can't do that.
But you're a magic.
Benny, now.
But what if I do something wrong?
Benny.
Benny, angry pirate and angry bounty hunter.
You'll only end up having a go at me again.
That's an order. Open the padlock. Now.
There's no time for discussion. Open the padlock. Now.
Is that your second wish?
We're still on the first one.
Yes. Yes, that's my second wish. Let it all out, Benny. It's you against the padlock.
Well, all right then.
I can explain.
The lamp belongs to me.
Oh, I'm happy to talk about it.
Iron Man over here is gonna kill us.
Uh-oh.
Oh, boy.
I wish I could comply to your request. Really.
Great. Awesome. That was superb.
The Archmage claims there are hardly any opportunities for the common citizen to improve their lot. The rich stay rich, the poor stay poor. That's nonsense, of course. Have you got that?
Nonsense. Yep, got it. He pleads for more education, for the poor as well. What do you say to that?
Too complicated. My party and I have found a simpler way. From tomorrow, anyone can be a winner in life. I present the lottery.
Wow.
And the winners can move from the lower town to the upper town.
The winner? Once a month, we grant one citizen from the lower town a better life in our midst. And you will report on it, Mr. Fox. The winner's new fabulous life and how I made it possible.
The winner. It's singular.
The first draw is tomorrow. I expect to see it all over the paper.
Very well, madam.
Spend it all in one place now. Great. Okay. Ooh, build a trader. Crane, goods. Interesting stuff around here. Okay, so, yeah, Wilbur's back. We're back as Wilbur, etc. Tune back next time when we, mess things up as Wilbur. See you then, and a bang bang boogie, and don't stop the boogie.